Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the final concert of the online Charlotte New Music Festival. We're so excited to have you join us here. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I think you're in for a real treat. Oh, hold on one second.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Always do that. Sorry. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed the show today, and I'm going to hand it right over to... this is actually a really cool concert because it's interactive electronic music. Using a computer program called Max, and I'm going to hand this over to the two guest artists that were teaching the workshop this week of all the pieces that have been created that you're going to hear today. So that would be Chris Dobrian and Charles Nichols. So Chris Dobrian, Dr. Dobrian, would you like to have a word about the concert today?
Sure, I'll be happy to do so. I wanted first of all to thank Charles and Elizabeth, who were the first people who contacted me about being a part of this. It's really been a pleasure, and I really appreciate your having invited me. So thanks very much to both of you. This class was co-taught by Charles Nichols and I. I taught the first week by myself, where the students were really just all beginning to learn about Max, and we started from square one and worked through a lot of different concepts, a lot of different computer programming techniques. And then Charles joined us in the second week to teach some more advanced techniques and to help people out as they developed pieces. So really every piece that you hear today is going to be a world premiere of a brand newly composed piece. And also a piece that has really gone from knowing, you know, little or nothing about Max to knowing how to really, you know, produce and develop one's own piece using that computer programming environment. So I'm really proud of all these folks for having done so well, and it's been such a great pleasure to have worked with all of you. I really think you folks are gonna hear some interesting stuff today. I also wanna thank all of the other Charlotte New Music Festival staff with whom I've worked, Emily and Serena and John, all the folks who've helped to make this possible. It's been really great working with all of you. I'm going to be quiet now and just introduce the first piece, unless Charles, you would like to say anything else before we get started.
No, I'd just like to thank you and thank Elizabeth for a great workshop, and thanks to all the participants for your excellent work.
Okay, so in terms of further emceeing, all I'm going to do is just introduce the performers one by one, the performers slash composers, and they in turn will introduce their own piece and then present it to you. So the first person on the program is John Kosh.
Hello. So for my piece, I took some inspiration from Ligeti, and I created four metronomes that were slightly different tempi so that they would kind of phase in and out of each other, and each assigned to a different pitch so that it would make up a larger chord. And so this kind of created this shifting accompaniment for me over which to improvise on the piano with a jazz background that was an interesting concept to me. And so I have some devices that I then developed in Max that allow me to kind of shape the arc of this piece and control different parameters. So I'm able to add delay to my piano. I can change the notes of the chord with my sustain pedal and things like that. So I start from this basically static texture and build to cacophony and come back. And this whole process was very meditative for me. And so I decided to just call this meditation number one. Thank you. Thank you.
Good job, John. Thank you. The next piece is by Jack Edwards.
Hi. So my piece is based on a program which takes a sample and then duplicates it up to 32 times. And then each duplication is either pitch shifted, well, it is pitch shifted, and then pan randomly between two speakers or left and right of the headphones. It creates a sound that seems really simple on the surface, but if you take time and listen to it, you hear this massive amorphous moving texture kind of under the surface. So the piece is made up of a patchwork of these different samples, I think six, all going through this program, and it creates this really alien and almost delirious mood at times. It hovers around a very subdued volume, occasionally growing into something a little more substantial before it finally expands to this massive feverish climax that begins to distort and feed back on itself before it all of a sudden just cuts out. I hope you like it. Let me just... Thanks.
Thanks, Jack. Very well done. The next person on the program is Dimitri Hunter.
Hello, everyone. So in these 2 weeks, is my first time using Max. So I wanted to really explore the program. So when we learned about using chords and also pitches randomly, I thought it would be an interesting way to see how the computer can make chord progressions on their own and melodies on their own. So I explored that and also wanted to create with this piece a atmosphere, like limbo type thing of like, it's very static, but it moves through different textures with layering of different voices. And I wanted to also make it interactive so you could put in any video with these sounds and try to layer them yourself in a way and kind of improv and see what you are feeling from those videos that you put in. So hope you guys enjoy. And there's the piece.
Thank you. Well done. Great work. The next performance will be by Jennifer Merkowitz.
Hi, everybody. I'm coming to you just from outside Columbus, Ohio. And these past couple weeks, I was focusing on making a patch that was very user-friendly for a performer to be able to step through with different cues. And so I designed something that can be used with either a MIDI foot pedal, or in today's example, I am actually going to be using an Xbox controller to perform the piece. So I'm using buttons to change events, sound file cues, settings for effects, and things like that. And I'm also using triggers and joysticks to control volumes and settings of effects in real time. So the material of this piece, I want to thank my boys, Isaac and Dominic, for giving me some ideas and for providing some of the musical material for this piece. So you'll hear that. There's lots of chopping up of voices and things like that. So I had a lot of fun making this, and I hope you have fun listening to it. And this piece is called Fuzzy. All right. Oops, hold on. Forgot to check the boxes.
Fuzzy was he working so much he 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 Fuzzy,
thank you.
Good job, Jennifer. Thank you. The next piece is by Justin Zeitlinger.
Hi, I'm Justin, and my piece is called Strike Shine Overlap 2. And it's called that because I felt that it was very strongly related to an earlier acoustic piece for string quartet that I wrote. And it's for violin and electronics. And all the material of the piece is derived from the sound of a bell that I had saved on my computer. And what I did was I took that sound and analyzed it in a program called Spear, and basically looked for the frequency components of that sound and recreated it in my Max Patch. So what you'll hear in the piece is me improvising on violin over the pure sine tones that make up the sound of the bell, as well as the actual sampled bell sound itself, which is played in reverse. And my violin is tuned microtonally to kind of fit into this imagined spectrum of the bell. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Thanks very much, Justin. That was great. I'm really enjoying the wide variety of styles and sounds that we're hearing. And I think that's going to continue in the next couple of pieces. The next piece is by Steve Chauvet and features Jessica Lindsey on bass clarinet.
Hi, everyone. I'm Steve. And this piece is called Probably for Bass Clarinet and Electronics and featuring Jessica Lindsey. So the idea of Probably is it's sort of a collaboration or jam session, if you will, between a human improvising and a computer improvising, and a lot of different probability distributions affect the essentially randomly generated improvisation of a drum set, but the probability of certain things being more likely than others hopefully gives it a feeling of not completely arbitrary randomness, but sort of controlled randomness. Yeah, please enjoy.
The next person on the program is Wendell Liefstedt.
Hello. My name is Wendell, and my piece is called Wellspring, and it is a about a 3.5 minute piece that is sort of a rhythmic, ambient texture with lots of different sections. It features my friend Caitlin reading a passage from a very meaningful book to me called Agua Viva by Clarissa Spector. And when I think about the piece, I think about water imagery, that sort of thing, and having depth and surface at the same time. So what you'll be seeing is a little simple visualizer I made, and this is the patch on the side. It's not active right now, so we'll be seeing the visualizer in the recording.
I know you all over because I have lived you all over. In me, life is profound. The early hours find me pale from having lived the night of deep dreams. Though sometimes I float on a visible shoal that has beneath it dark blue, almost black depths. That is why I write to you. On a waft of thick seaweed and in the tender wellspring of love.
There it is.
Great. Good job, Wendell. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
And the final piece on this concert will be by Lily Koslov.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for coming to our show. Before I present my piece, I just want to say thank you to a few people. Big thank you to Jessica Lindsey for the amazing bass clarinet samples that I got to use in this piece. I want to thank my cousin Aaron Siegel for helping me out with the videography element of this piece. And Also a big thank you to Charles and Chris for being our amazing teachers and helping us out this week, giving us a lot of tools and a lot of wise knowledge about Max. I learned a lot. And then lastly, I just want to thank Elizabeth for organizing this. So thank you. Today I'll be presenting my piece called Cake Smash. And I was kind of inspired by this idea of taking something really beautiful and perhaps something refined and kind of deconstructing it, taking it apart, and, you know, tearing it apart through a variety of means. So, and then just kind of using that entropy to build up some dramatic intensity. So, let me share the patch with you first. So this is kind of the score that I was working with. So I have these electronics and then also my own live voice was going into it. So I just kind of followed these steps and slowly added in these different processes that kind of tore apart the Mozart. And maybe I don't want to give away too much, but a couple details I did get to use some samples from Jessica. And I also sampled this local ice cream truck that comes down my street every few days. So I just thought I would kind of incorporate different aspects of the classical tradition and kind of all the ways that they've been manipulated throughout time. So this is kind of what I was working with visually. And then let's watch the video. Actually, let me just make sure that I will be sharing audio as well. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lily. Great work. Well, I want to thank all of you in the audience for attending this this concert of computer music. And thanks to my fellow instructor, Charles, and especially thanks to all 8 composers for your very interesting and imaginative and impressive work. Really appreciate it. One more virtual round of applause for all of you. And at this point, I'm going to pass the mic back to Elizabeth to wrap up the program. Thanks very much.
Thank you so much, Chris. I really appreciate you being here. Charles, is there anything you would like to add to this? Is there anything you'd like to speak about the week and the process and the concert?
No, I just wanted to thank Jessica Lindsey because I'd forgotten to thank her at the beginning of the concert. Thanks very much for, this is your third year of participating and adding your talent to, availing your talent to the participants. So really appreciate that. Thank you, Elizabeth.
Thank you. Thank you, Jessica, as well. Thank you to all the composers and thank you for everybody. This should be the last concert of the Charlotte New Music Festival, but we had to reschedule one, so there's still one last one next week, July 2nd. It's RPE Duo. It's not an official festival concert, but it's something we like to include, so we're going to put them back on the bandwagon for July 2nd. So anyway, tune in there. Thank you so much, everybody, for tuning in, and I hope you have a great rest of your day. Talk to you later. See you later.